Myself, Hirdesh. I am delivering the lecture on operating system. The subject is included in 5th semester of computer technology. The subject carries 70 marks on theory, practical assessment 30 marks is there, and the internal practical is a 50 marks. So total 150 marks carries for this subject. Now we go for the actual syllabus of this subject. The first chapter of this subject is an overview of the operating system. Inside the overview of the operating system chapter, the first point, that is a 1.1, is a concept. Before concentrating on the concept of the operating system, some terms we revise, that is a software. As you know, the software is already covered in a software in an engineering syllabus in a 4th semester. The software is nothing but it is a collection of the program which fulfill the user applications. The user applications means user desires. Then further, the software is divided into two parts. The first part is an application software. Application software, and the second part is a system software. The application software, it is the softwares which fulfills the user applications, and the system software are the softwares which assist the system itself. It means it provides environments or suitable environments for executing the system. So we can say that the software or system software, nothing but it is a operating system. Further, to clearly or deeply defining the operating system, we consider this diagram. This diagram is a computer system components diagram. In this diagram, the first is a user. Then the user applications, or simply we can say these are the user programs, or maybe it is a user interface. Then operating itself is there. Then it is a hardware. Hardware means all the hardware of the computer system. It includes I/O devices, peripheral devices, etc. Here clearly shows that the operating system is placed in between user applications and hardware of the computer system. So we can say that the user performing his job or his desires or his applications by using operating system, by using user applications through the operating system. So we can say that the operating system is nothing but it is a software program which creates interaction in between hardware and user applications. The user applications helps to fulfill the user requirements. So we can say that the operating system may create interaction in between user and the computer hardware. Now we define the operating system in other way. The operating system is a software program which provides the efficient environment for executing efficiently the user's program on the user's applications. Now we will consider on the operating system components. The components means which services or which components are provided by the operating system. The component means its services. Here, the operating system is a software program which provide or which assist the users to execute their program on a computer hardware. So, first service is provided by the operating system is nothing but the file manager, or we can say it as simply file management system. Inside a file management system, the number of activities are provided by the operating system. The file management, inside this, the file management, the first service is a create file, then delete, then manipulate, and then mapping. Here, file management component, the user can create the directory or files or new directory or files, then it can delete the existing files or unwanted files, and then it can manipulate the user files, and then the mapping, he or she can map operating system mapping the user files into the secondary storage management. So under the file management component, these all points are covered. Now we go towards the next point, that is a process management component. Process management component. Under this, first we define the process. The process is nothing but the instance or the instance of a program which is in a current execution. Or simply we can say the program is in execution, that is called as a process. Basically, the program constitutes from number of processes or number of processes which are in an appropriate sequence. So, whenever we go for the execution of the program, that time the number of processes wants to be executed concurrently. Here, the concurrent execution of the processes will be arise, and that time it is necessary to manage the number of processes or the concurrent execution of that process, because whenever the number of processes or more than one process want to be executed at a same CPU time or at a on a same device, that time there occur a conflict in between. So the process management provide the process scheduling. Inside process scheduling, it performs process communication. Inside the process management, provide the process communication. By using the process communication facility, the processes are stop another process from the interference in between each other. So, in under the process management component, the first service is a create a new process, then delete the existing or unwanted processes, then suspension of the process which is in a current execution, suspension of current process which is in a current execution, then resumption of the suspended process, and then resumption of the suspended process. All these activities are performed under the process management component. After this, the another component, that is the storage management. The storage management here, the storage is basically divided into two parts, that is a primary area and the next one is a the secondary storage. In a primary area or primary storage, the first activity of OS, it keeps tracks on tracks on primary area, because the primary area or the primary memory is less than the secondary storage, and the primary area is basically used for the execution of a in a temporary manner, because primary area is considered as a work area where the user can retrieve the required programs data from the secondary storage. It will update it, it will process it, and after the processing and after the completion of the execution, it will be stored in back to the secondary storage. And as you know, the secondary storage is nothing but it is the permanent residence of the user programs, system softwares, all the things which are stored in a computer system. So this point is covered in a storage management. Then the next one is a device management. Basically, the device, there are number of devices which are connected to the computer system. Then inside the computer system, the CPU, it is a device, but we consider the CPU time is also one type of a resource or device. Then IO devices, then another peripheral devices. Whenever the process or a program wants to execute, that time they are requested for the CPU time as well as IO devices as well as the peripheral devices. Whenever the computers are connected to the network, that time they will share the resources. Under this, whenever number of computers are requested for the same device or same resource, that time the operating system will manage it. It will decide which way or which system will allocate which resource, and as per the allocation of the allocation by the operating system, all the processes utilize the devices. So the device manager or the resource utilization or the resource sharing, it is the main feature of the operating system or main component of the operating system, where it increases the throughput of the system, or it minimizes the cost of the resources. And then the network management, inside the network management component, the operating system keep tracks on the connections in between the computers. It also performs the routing inside the network. And the last one, the security management. Inside the security management, the operating system will provide the security and protection to the computer, to the data or files which are stored in a computer system. So the component of, under the component of the operating system, all these points are covered. Now we move towards the next point, that is nothing but the types of an operating system. Types of an operating system. The types of an operating system, it depends on the nature of the operating system. Nature means how it works. There are many types, but we primarily concentrate on the batch operating system, because this type is included in your syllabus. The batch word itself suggests that there are the collection of same nature entities. If we consider it in point of computer language or in the point of computer field, that time here are nothing but the programs which are completed, accomplish the task of the users, that shares same resource, same data, as well as the same software. In a batch operating system, such as same nature programs are considered as a job and from job 1 to job n, collectively all this collection is considered as a batch, and the batch operating system will execute this program batch wise. For execution of this job, the batch operating system divide the memory into two parts. In these two parts, the first part is a the primary area. The first part is a primary area. Already we have covered that. In a primary area, we can execute the program in a temporary manner. And the secondary area, it is a permanent residence of the user program. So the jobs are stored in a secondary memory, and as per the requirement of the user, that job will be retrieved in the primary area for the execution. For constituting this job, the operating system uses a JCL. The JCL nothing but is a job control language. By using this language, the job is considered as the instructions. The first instruction, that is a job begin, and the block of statements include, and after that the last statement, that is a job end statement. Whenever the operating system encounter the job begin statement, it will start on the execution of that specific job, and it executes line by line till it encounters the job end statement. And after encountering the job end statement, the operating system will go for the next job. As this fashion, it will execute all the jobs. So in a batch operating system, all the same nature jobs are executed in this fashion. But the limitation of a batch operating system is that in a batch operating system, the interactive session is impossible, because the batch operating system doesn't support to interaction. Whenever we submit a single program or a single job for the execution, that time after only completion of that execution of the job, the operating system or batch operating system will be responsive. In between the execution, it will not be interact with the user, so it is a limitation. So basically, the batch operating system is utilized only when the program or user program takes a longer time for the execution. I want to conclude this my session. Today we have covered the concept of the operating system as well as components of the operating system, and the inside the type of operating system there is a single or one type of operating system, that is the batch operating system. In a next session, we will cover further part. So, thank you.